I'm gonna do an assessment, so just make sure that I don't break protocol or breach, have a protocol breach, okay?
On the sixth floor of the Kaiser Permanente Medical Center in Oakland, clinical nurse specialist Shane Char demonstrates the training protocols he has been practicing for weeks. Char is dressed in personal protective equipment from head to toe that's designed to keep fluid away from every inch of his skin. He's one of dozens of nurses, physicians, and staff in Oakland who have volunteered to care for patients with Ebola virus disease in this critical care unit.
Does that hurt? Do you have any pain?
According to protocol, Char cares for the patient while another nurse watches for potential problems with the protective equipment and stands by to assist. Two other nurses monitor from outside the negative pressure room, ready to suit up and help if necessary. Next door is the anteroom, where caregivers are trained to safely remove their protective equipment.
There's a lot of collaboration going on, a lot of intense drills and simulations with the adult ICU, with pediatric ICU, with the ED, with our transport services to make sure that we're completely ready.
With public concern about Ebola virus disease running high, members of the media were invited to visit the Oakland Medical Center, which is one of two Kaiser Permanente Northern California inpatient Ebola care centers.
So what you're going to see here today is Kaiser Permanente's commitment to safety for both our healthcare workers, our patients, as well as our community.
We're constantly looking at what's evolving through the CDC and the international medical community to make sure that we are either exceeding or meeting the guidelines that are being proposed.
The key thing with Ebola virus disease is to identify it, isolate it, and then provide the appropriate protection. Every single frontline staff member throughout Kaiser Permanente has received training on early identification and early isolation. And then we have specialized teams that have received training for appropriate personal protective equipment to provide advanced level care.
An important part of the training for this unit is the careful process of putting on and taking off the personal protective equipment. It's done with another trained caregiver watching and a checklist to ensure that no one is exposed to the virus. It takes about 15 minutes to put the equipment on safely and about 30 minutes to take it off.
I think I can speak for all of us that we feel proud to be part of Kaiser to prepare for this because we feel like we are ready.
This is not something that every single frontline staff member needs to learn. We need to have the people in those specialized units with this type of equipment and with this type of training.
I'd like to recognize and acknowledge all the staff that volunteered for the specialty unit. It makes us proud as nurses and physicians that people care about the patients in our community, because that's the calling of nursing, is to care for the community wherever that is needed.